हेलो फ्रेंड्स, डॉक्टर रीता हियर। वी आर मीटिंग आफ्टर अस क्वाइट लॉन्ग टाइम दिस टाइम। एज यू ऑल आर अवेयर, वी एंड आवर मेंटर डॉक्टर बी एस भोसले सर एट आशा होम्योपैथी क्लिनिक आर गोइंग टू स्पीक अबाउट फ्यू क्रिस्प पॉइंट्स ऑन स्नेक्स वर्सेस द स्पाइडर्स। आई एम हियर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू टू स्पीक अबाउट स्नेक्स। व्हेन वी स्पीक अबाउट रेमेडीज एंड व्हेन वी आर Differentiating remedies of different families, it is little easier when we study about metals or when we study about plants, animal kingdom differently, it is little easier. But when we come to study remedies in the same family, differentiating the remedies in the same family, there are very fine line differentiations which we have to take note of so that we can prescribe rightly and we can reach the right simile. Today I am going to speak about two snakes, that is Lachecis and Crotalus horridus. These both snakes come from the same family, that is Viperidae family. So the differentiation is very subtle between these two snakes. When we see about snakes in general, snakes remedies are very agile. Their ambush in nature, the common characteristics is suspiciousness, jealousy, playing conspiracies, making plannings, hideous in nature, keeping thoughts and secrets to themselves, will not trust easily on anybody, are more passionate. These are the general characteristics of snakes. When we study snakes' remedies, these general characteristics come to our mind first. But how to differentiate finely between Lachecis and Crotalus horridus? That is what I will just speak about. Talking about Lachecis, when Lachecis patient comes to our clinic, what we notice is, wow, so jovial, so expansive, so much talkative, that is loquacity. He'll be talking about many topics. He'll be more expressive and very friendly with us when we see Lachecis. When Lachecis enters the clinic, we feel he's so communicative to us and he'll have so many ideas to tell to us. He will have so many thought processes to tell to us. He's coming to us with a single disease. He might be coming with any sepsis infection, he might be coming with vertigo, he might be coming with any uterine, she might be coming with any uterine complaints. But she will have so many things to tell about those complaints. They are very elaborative. That is what is Lachecis is. Lachecis, the bush master, they are one of the nastiest snakes. They do not wait or they do not take time to attack. As soon as they find any danger, they will attack. That is the doctrine of signature of Lachecis. Similarly, in Lachecis patients, they will not trust people. And when the time of revenge comes, they will not wait to take the revenge. They will have their planning in hand ready. They will have their format ready, how to take the revenge or how to execute a plan, and they will do it. This is what Lachecis is. Lachecis is also very jealous. They will always have that competitiveness in them. They want to be better. They want to show better than what their other person is, other partner is, other friend is. So they will always be in a competitive mode. Lachecis is one of the anxious drugs as well. To whom they are attached or loved, they always have that fear that something will happen to their loved ones. Or that generally we take a rubric that delusions, death of. Lachecis will have delusion that he has committed some crime, delusions that he is under some superpower, under control of some superpower. That is what Lachecis will show us. Lachecis is a left-sided remedy. It is a warm-blooded remedy. More of its affections will be from tight clothings. Dr. Herring had proved this, and after while proving Lachecis, he couldn't bear the collars. He couldn't bear wearing tight collars, so he had to keep them loosing. This is probably due to the affections of Lachesis on the pneumogastric nerves. As Lachesis sleeps into aggravation, when they are sleeping, they feel that their respiration will stop. They feel that constrictionness. So they sleep into aggravation due to the pathological action of Lachesis on the pneumogastric nerves. Also, when we see the doctrine of signature of Lachesis, the skin is very sensitive. They are the pit vipers. So they have the feeling of danger. They can sense the feeling of danger from their skin. Similarly, in the Lachesis patients, they are very touchy, unlike Lycopodium, Nux vomica, Epis, Aconite. They are aggravated by slightest touch because of the sensitivity to the peripheral nerves. That is the action of Lachesis on the peripheral nerves. In Lachesis, this touchiness is due to the action on the peripheral nerves, whereas in Arnica, Epis, it is due to the inflammation. In Lachesis, there is no inflammation. But there is touchiness. They are aggravated by slight touch, slight pressure. Lachesis is a remedy for high blood pressure, circulation problems. They are better by lying on the left side of the body. When Lachesis comes to you, they will be very vibrant. They will be showy. But you will always observe in them that they are jumping from one topic to another. They have so many things to tell to you. They will not constantly stick to one point. Also, when they are giving you his case, he will be observant. What is going around? Who is the receptionist? Who is bringing the water? Who is making the medicines? What is happening in the clinic? They are very observant. They are very alert. So they will be observing you. And they are very passionate. Lachesis is more of overstimulation, internal overstimulation, which is seeking out an outlet. In normal routine life, Lachesis patients are responsibility oriented. They will take responsibilities, they will make good plannings, they can execute their plans in a proper directed manner. Lachesis are religious, they are God fearing, they are conscientious remedies to what they are doing. They will believe in God, they have faith in God, they will not forget to do their religious activities. Lachesis is always having aggravation by suppressed discharges. When the discharges are suppressed or when the discharges are not flowing, for example in climaxes, in postmenopausal ladies, Lachesis works very well. They need an outlet for their internal emotions, so discharges are important. So speaking out, loquacity is important in Lachesis. When you find Lachesis in the later stages, in deeper stages, when they are into delirium, they will be muttering. But in that delirium also, they will be constantly speaking and they will be alert. They will not go into a very soporous condition, but they will be alert. Coming to Crotalus horridus, both Crotalus horridus and Lachesis are remedies which act on the hemorrhagic system, on the hematic system of the body. So both are bleeders. This was about Lachesis. Let's talk about Crotalus horridus. So Crotalus also works on the hemorrhagic system, on the circulatory system of the body. So in Crotalus as well as in Lachesis, the respiratory and the circulatory system is affected. What is Crotalus horridus? Crotalus horridus is a timberwood rattlesnake. It is a huge snake. The tail of the snake has hardened skin, which makes a rattling sound whenever it senses a danger around it. So Crotalus will always be a snake is a snake which gives warnings, which will rattle its tail before an attack. It is not a quick attacking snake. It will wait, it will snarl at you, it will stare at you, it will give you a warning, and then it will attack. Similarly, when Crotalus comes to your clinic, how it manifests? It is a huge patient, slow, little, will take time. No doubt it is also loquacious, but it will take time. When Crotalus horridus is a warm-blooded person, but Crotalus is more of a sad, always into a tearful mood. It is not as loquacious as Lachesis. It is loud. Crotalus, when comes to us, will mostly come for complaints of sepsis, hemorrhages. It works very well in conditions of sepsis, otoria, or any other naming disease. But sepsis is one of the keys in Crotalus. There is hemorrhage, bleeding from any orifice of the body. It works well in malignant tumors, malignant conditions. In Crotalus also there is aggravation from sleep. But Lachesis sleeps into aggravation, Crotalus wakes from aggravation in sleep. In Crotalus, loquacity is there, but Crotalus will keep on mumbling words, will have little of indifference when he is speaking to you. He is not much interested in telling all his history, or he is not jumping from one topic to another. But he will have mumbling of words. He will forget words. He will misplace words. To one word, he will tell some another word. And he knows that he is doing that. That is what Crotalus does. When we speak about Crotalus horridus snakes are the snakes who live in families. They will not leave their families and go away. They live in groups. Similarly, in Crotalus patients, they are family-oriented patients. They are responsibility-oriented people. If anybody in the family is not well, they feel that I am responsible for my family's unwell. It is not just out of love. They love their family, but it is out of more sense of responsibility and duty that towards their family, that they are responsible for their well-being. Just similar to the doctrine of signature of Crotalus. So they always will have a fear or delusion that they have committed crime. Delusions that they have not done their duties well. Delusion that they are surrounded by enemies and they have to protect their families from their enemies. Also, Crotalus will have delusions that they are falling from the bed. They are surrounded by their enemies. They have frightful imaginations. In later stages, Crotalus, who is very responsible and sensitive to the family, they can become indifferent. They can have apathy towards their own family members. In the extreme stages, and when in delirious stages, Crotalus is more muttering, mumbling, is not clear, is not that loquacious. Crotalus is a right-sided remedy. In Crotalus, there is more difficulty in wearing tight clothes around the abdomen. In Lachesis, it was more tight clothes around the neck, because Crotalus has more profound action on the gastric system and on the liver. So, the tightness around the abdomen is more felt in Crotalus. Crotalus can be taskmasters. They can also take good decisions and do activities in a planned manner. But they have huge fears. They feel, they have apprehensions that how their work will be done. So, going to the final step, fine line differentiations of Crotalus and Lachesis. Crotalus is a rattlesnake. Lachesis is the bushmaster. Lachesis is more loquacious than Crotalus. Crotalus is mostly mumbling, muttering, mistakes in words, more apathetic remedy. Lachesis is more flamboyant, energetic, more interactive remedy when we see the person when he enters the clinic. Crotalus has tightness around the abdomen. Lachesis has the tightness around the neck due to the pathognomic actions on the different spheres in both the remedies. Crotalus will be a composed person, huge. Like I says, you will feel as if it is more friendly to us. He has told everything to you and he is so much close to you. And he keeps on jumping from one topic to another. So these few fine lines of differentiation, when you come and elaborate between these two remedies, the prescription will be very much easier for you if you observe in this way. So observation is one of the key factors in differentiating these two remedies. Also, most of the times when Lachesis has done half of the work and remaining is not getting cured, you can also think about Crotalus horridus. Both these remedies resemble to us as higher mineral remedies, or like Mercurius, Aurums, because they are responsibility takers, because they are doing the taskmasters. But the element of suspiciousness, jealousy, planning is more prominent in these two snakes. So in this way you can differentiate these remedies. Also, to learn more, I would like to invite you all to our sirs, our mentors, Dr. B.S. Bhosle sir's workshop, which is on 28th to 31st of January at Panchgani. So we can dig more, we can learn more in repertory ki paathshala, signify and amplify more about repertories, and we can learn more about snakes, more about spiders and other rubrical understandings. Thank you, friends.